Okay guys, so welcome to the new class. So this is a new chapter. We'll start work, power and energy. Am I correct? Siddhi, is this chapter, is there in your book?
Yes.
Yeah. So what is work? What is work, Pritham? What is work?
Work is the...
What is work? If I say formula wise, I will say F dot S. F dot S. Okay. Work is basically a scalar product. It's a scalar product. Why? You remember I told you that. Remember I taught you that there is a dot product of two vectors. If there is a dot product of two vectors, you will get what? Scalar. Yes or no? For a dot product of two vectors, you will get scalar. But a cross product of two vectors, what you will get? You will get a
vector.
So since F is a vector, S is a vector, the dot product of two vectors will always give a scalar. That's why work is a scalar quantity. Clear? Clear? Okay. And what is its unit? Its unit is what? Joules. Clear? Clear? Work is joules. So what is positive work? What is negative work? If the system does work, system gains energy, we say it is positive work. Gains energy, it's positive work. If system loses energy, it's called negative work. Clear? Clear? We are using fundamentals. Okay. These are the fundamentals. Then what is variable? What is variable force? Then basically when I say work is nothing but F dot S. This is a what? Constant force applied for a particular displacement gives a work. Here it is a constant force. But when I talk about variable force, let's say my force is varying at each moment, then what will happen? Then the work will be variable. That means for this particular length till this much, I'm applying maximum force. Here it is varying. Here it is F1. Here it is F2. Here it is F3. Here it is F4. Here it is F5. Then, and here it is S1, S2, S3, S4, S5. So at particular instant for this much, your W will be what? W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4. Plus W5. Why? Because here force is varying. So what will be W1? W1 will be F1 into S1. W2 will be... 1 minute. Laksh, kidhar hai tu? Class, tere ko pata nahi hai, 5:30 baje class rehta hai? Matlab mere ko remind karunga kya, Laksh? आधा घंटा चालू हो गया, जल्दी ज्वाइन कर रहा है, जल्दी ज्वाइन कर। W1, W2, W3, W4. So for W1 it will be F1 in dot S1, W2 will be F2 dot S2. So like that you will have Fn dot Sn. So here it is basically what? Here we are fixed. It is fixed so that we can add it. But let's say the it is varying at each moment. Then what will happen? Then we'll integrate with a integration. It will be x1 to x2, here it will be f dot dx. Why? Because the here it is fixed. It is basically integration. We are talking about force varying at each particular moment. This small, it's a basically small displacement. And what is x1, x2? It's a limit. Till what to what? x1 till x2. Particular moment. So, either the force might be varying or the displacement might be varying. either or, if both are varying, then also we get a variable work. And if one is varying, then also you get a variable work. Clear? Are we clear? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
It is not necessary that if displacement is zero, total work done also is zero. Means what? Displacement, you remember, I told you, right? There is a point A and there is a point B. If, let's say, you want to go from A to B and then you come to B to A, then what happens? Your displacement becomes what? Zero? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
But remember, even if the displacement is zero, that doesn't mean that what? The work is zero. Why? We will come back to it. So remember, work done is not zero. Sorry. What I'm saying, it is not necessary that if displacement is zero, work done means if the displacement is zero, it is not necessary that work done will become zero. Work done will still have a value, and I will come to this. Please remind me, I will come to that. Okay?
Sir, actually, like, if displacement is zero, then the work done is zero, sir.
No. Who said?
Yes, sir. Work done is equal to force into displacement of units, sir.
Correct.
Yes, sir. So then, displacement is zero, then work done is zero, sir.
There is a concept called conservative force, non-conservative force. I will come to that. That's why I told you it is not so. It is not so. Guys, 1 minute. So, Pritam, there is a concept called conservative force, non-conservative force. Understood? So, we'll come to that. Then only we'll understand. Okay? You will understand.
Sir, actually, the net work done is zero, sir. Yes, sir. I know that, sir, about conservative and non-conservative.
Okay. That's what I'm trying to say.
But the net work done is zero, sir.
Net work done is zero. I did not say net work done, no? I did not say net work done is not zero. Net work done is obviously zero. You do work here. Correct?
Yes, sir.
The net work done is zero. But I am not talking about net work done. I am talking about only work. Clear?
Oh.
I have not come to that. Yes, so hold on. Don't get confused. You studied, others have not studied. I'll come to that. Clear, all of you? So we'll teach you what is conservative force. First, we'll understand what is conservative force. So what do you know about conservative force, Pritam? Pritam, what is conservative force?
The work done by such force, it does not depend on the path taken by the object, sir.
Correct. So that means these forces are independent or do not depend on the path. Means if I'm going to from A to B, whether you go like this or whether you go like this or whether you go like this, it does not matter. It matters what is the initial point and what is the final point. If any force which is not dependent on the path, but only depends on the initial and final point, then these forces are called conservative force. And what are the examples of those forces? One is gravitational force. Clear? Next is electrostatic force. And then it is spring force. Clear? These forces are called conservative force. They are not dependent on the path, but only depend on initial and final position. Clear? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And remember, the work done by such forces in a closed path is always zero, which is Pritam is trying to say. The work done by these forces in a closed path means closed path is always zero. Clear? The work done by conservative force in a closed path is always zero. Then what is non-conservative force? Obviously, it will depend on path. Clear? Then what are the example of non-conservative force, Pritam?
Friction, sir.
Friction and what else? What else? Friction, any type of friction? Yeah, all type of friction. It can be air friction. Okay. It can be water friction. And also surface tension?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And also buoyancy? Buoyant force.
I'm not sure about that. Like,
yeah, buoyant force also is one of the non-conservative force. Okay? So if you want to summarize what is conservative force, non-conservative force? Conservative force, non-conservative force. Conservative force are path independent. These are path dependent. Okay? Okay? In conservative path, if I have two final points, this is W1, this W2. Here W1 is equal to W2. But here, W1 and W2 is not same. Remember that. In a closed path, it is always zero. Work is always zero. But here, work is not equal to zero. Examples, gravitational force, electrostatic force, spring force. Here it is, buoyant force, friction, and surface tension. We'll come to surface tension later on. Clear? Okay. Yeah. Siddhi clear, Swarup clear.
Sir. Okay. Sir, clear, sir.
Laksh, this is the final time. Huh? I am not going to remind. Guys, my job is not to remind you that you have class. Class is there at particular time. Everybody should know and join. I am not going to put any message further henceforth. Class will be in Zoom always. Same ID. If there is any changes, I will reply. If class is being not held, I will reply. If I am not reply, that means class is going on the normal time. I am not going to stop. I will wait only till 5 minutes max. If somebody has a problem, they should inform me, sir, I have a problem. I am not able to join anything. Clear? Everybody yes, clear? My job is not to remind you. My job is to... Have I seen any time that I am late? No. I treat it very seriously. If I am late, I will inform everybody that I am late because of some network issue. That cannot happen. Maybe once or twice it might would have happened, but I'm not sure anytime it happens. I don't like, first of all. These are, you are studying, guys. It's a very hard year. Please understand. Please try to use the opportunity. Whoever is teaching, wherever you are getting proper coaching, please take up. Now see, Lux, your class didn't start. Do you know that how kitna piche ho tum? अभी क्या सीन है क्लास का? Is it going to start or not? Laksh, what about your class? Sir. Is it going to start?
No, sir. It hasn't started yet.
CBSE already started. Pritam is almost half the way. That's why I always tell CBSE. Because they are very professional. Dates are announced. Exam dates are announced already. So that you don't have a fear. I don't know why they are spoiling my future. Okay, have you written down this point? Shall I go ahead?
Sir, what yes, are the sir. Examples for non-conservative, sir? Friction,
surface tension, buoyancy.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir, you can erase it.
Okay. So now you have a force. You have a force which is a three-dimensional force. I can write this force as Fx I cap, Fy j cap, and Fz k cap. If any force is conservative, if any force is conservative, then what happened? Your dFx, dou Fx by dou y is equal to dou Fy by dou, 1 minute, huh? Yeah, dou x. Dou Fx by dou F dou z is equal to dou Fz by dou x. And then dou Fy by dou z equal to dou Fz by dou y. Now, what is dou? Anybody knows? What is this dou? Does anybody know what is dou? What is this called? It's called partial differentiation. What it is called? Partial differentiation. Yes or no? Are you aware? Was it taught? Yes?
No,
no, don't worry. We will teach you. So, what is differentiation? Differentiation, partial differentiation means you are only partially differentiating. So, how to do it, we will see later on. Clear? Just note down this.
Sir, 1 second, sir. I will copy this.
Yeah, note down. We will see how it happens. Just note down. Siddhi, you didn't learn this 11th?
No, sir, I don't remember.
Don't remember? How will you prove if force is conservative or not?
By head board.
Shall we go ahead? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So when I say force is conservative, I have a force which is x I cap plus y j cap plus 0 k cap. Then when I say dou fx by dou y means what? I am differentiating this component with respect to y. Now tell me, y is equal to x square. If I say dy by dx, it means what? X to the power nx to the power n minus 1, which is equal to 2x. Yes or no? This you would have learned. Correct or not? That means this one you are respecting with respect to x, because it's a variable. Y is a what variable? Dependent variable. X is an independent variable. You are differentiating an independent variable, with respect to x. But now you tell me x, if I say dou x by dou y, can I differentiate x with respect to y? X and y are two different variables which are not in relation. That means dou x by dou y will become what? Zero. That means x is not changing with respect to y. X is constant with respect to y. So your dou x with respect to y will be zero. Similarly, your dou y, the y component. Prema, I'm in a class. Can I call you back? So dou y with respect to dou x. Now, this one with respect to x is not this thing, it is constant. So dou y by dou x is also zero. Clear? If this is zero, this is zero, that means both are equal. Clear? Now, clear or not?
Sir, can I explain this again, sir? I'm not able to understand.
Are Baba, it's a x component. What is this? This is the x component. Now you want to differentiate the x component with respect to y. Can you differentiate x component with respect to y? No. You can't differentiate.
Yes, sir.
X and y are irrelevant. X is maybe a constant for y. So dx by dy is zero. Similarly, dy by dx will be zero. Clear? Clear? See, what is fx? Fx is the x component of the force. You want to trying to differentiate fx component of the force. You are trying to differentiate with y. So fx has no relation with y. That's why it is zero. If all these are zero, then it is what? It is conservative. Force is conservative. Clear? Understood?
Sir, all this should be equal or it should be zero, sir?
It will be equal only when it is zero, no? It cannot be equal. Only when it is zero, only it can be equal.
Sir, it can be some constant, no, sir? Like
no, it cannot be. It cannot be.
Okay.
It cannot be, no? How it will be? You tell me how it will be, how you will get a constant. Here it will be x square, it will be y square. It cannot be. Not possible.
Oh, okay, sir.
Okay, clear all of you? So remember, if F has to be a conservative force, then it will be this relation should exist. Clear? Yeah?
One second.
Yeah.
I will copy this.
Yeah. Laksh, Swarup, Siddhi.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Sir,
tell me.
Sir, what is the difference between D and dou, sir?
Okay, dou is partial differentiation. See, you have this is basically a vector, correct? You are differentiating everybody with respect to x. Then it is a normal differentiation, D. Okay?
Okay, sir.
But if you are differentiating variable with this x, y, partially you are differentiating, then it is dou. Like this.
Oh, okay, sir.
You will learn it in your grad days. Graduation you will study. Partial differentiation. Not now. Not required. Just remember this much. Why force is conservative? Force is conservative only when this holds. See, how will you remember? Fx, dx, dy, fy, dy, fy, y, fx, x, fz, z, fy, y, fz, z. Like this you will remember. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let us go to the next topic, work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. What is this? What is work energy theorem? Work done, write down. write down the definition of that. It means work done by all the forces. When I say all the forces, it means what? It means both internal force and external force. Work done by all the forces is equal to change in kinetic energy of the body. Change in kinetic energy of the body. Or I can write like this as K final minus KE initial. That's all. Clear, guys?
One second, sir.
Yeah. Lux, samajh mein aa raha
hai? Haan, sir.
Okay. Okay, on this we'll do a small problem. A 5 kg ball, a 5 kg ball falls through a height, falls through a height of 20 meter. Okay, falls through a height of 20 meter. Find the work done by the resistance. No, not this. 1 minute. A ball moving, a ball of 100 grams moving at a speed of 100 kilometer per hour, okay, a vehicle of 100 kg moving at a speed of 100 kilometer hour, okay, exceeds to a speed of 150 kilometer per hour. Clear? What is the work done? So how will you do? So now when the body was actually moving first, your V1 was how much? 100 kilometer per hour. It suddenly went to, this is the initial velocity, and the final velocity became 150 kilometer per hour. Am I correct? Yes or no? And the mass of the body vehicle is how much? 100 kg. I am saying, what is the work done? So what did we learn? That work done is nothing but change in the kinetic energy of the body. Now, initial kinetic energy become, what is the formula for kinetic energy? Half into half mv square. So if I say kinetic initial, it is half mv vi square. That means half into 100 kg into 100 square. And what is ke final? Ke final will be half into 100 kg into 150 into 150. Correct or not? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So if you divide, this will become 50. This will be 50. So basically what? This minus this. That means 150 square minus 100 square and multiplied with respect to 50. So this is basically what formula? A square minus B square formula. It will be 150 plus 100, 150 minus 100 into 50. So 150 plus 100 is 250, 150 minus 100 is 50, and you have already a 50. So 250 into 50 into 50. So it will be what? 625. How many zero? 1, 2, 3. That means 625 kilojoules. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Very easy for any easy problem. Koi dikkat hai kya?
No, sir.
No dikkat. No problem. Okay. Then, now we will go to. Now let us not teach anymore. I'll too much of concepts. We'll study in next class. So we have started the work energy theorem. We'll go to the advanced concept in the next class. Okay. I don't want to go ahead with the new chapter so much. Let us give a halt. So next class, guys, I request you to be on time. I'm not going to call upon. If somebody is not coming within 5 minutes, I'm going to start off. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
And recording will not be given to that person.
You yes, will not sir. Get recording that also. Will not happen again.
No, I'm talking about everybody, Laksh. I'm not telling only you. I'm talking about everybody. Every time it is happening that I am calling everybody. If somebody is joining late, please inform me that you are joining late. Clear? Clear, no? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Laksh, your class is on Monday, yeah? Monday, I am doing it on Monday and Tuesday. Not on Wednesday, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure.
Your morning class. Siddhi.
Yeah, 8:30, okay.
Yeah, 8:30. Siddhi, you had some doubts of kinetic energy theorem? We'll do it tomorrow. Please come back tomorrow to Lata ma'am's house, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Pritam, chalo, take care, all of you. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Yeah. Tell me.
It's the proof, sir, for this work energy theorem.
Proof, is it there in your syllabus?
Yes, sir.
I will do it in the tomorrow's class, okay?
Yes, sir. So tomorrow we don't have any class.
When I said tomorrow, it means next class I will do it, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just let me know whatever is missed because I might miss. So please, all of you, I request you to check your syllabus. What is there, what is not there, so that we are on the same page. That should be your duty, okay? Because you are different boards, all of you. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.